अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज़ लेक्चर इज़ अबाउट द एसिड बेस डिसऑर्डर्स, एसिड बेस इम्बैलेंस एंड यू कैन से एसिड बेस डिस्टर्बेंस। एज वी हैव रेड अबाउट द रेगुलेशन ऑफ एसिड बेस बैलेंस इन द बॉडी, पीएच मेंटेनेंस बाय डिफरेंट लाइंस ऑफ डिफेंस लाइक ब्लड बफर्स, रेस्पिरेटरी मैकेनिज्म एंड किडनी। Now we will discuss about different types of clinical conditions, clinical causes that may lead to a particular type of acidosis and a different specific type of alkalosis, and we will also discuss in detail how they are caused, how they will be diagnosed and how they will be treated. So a first disorder due to the acid base regulation, due to pH regulation, pH variation is acidosis. Acidosis is defined as the decrease in blood pH when the acidic load will be high in the body, when pH will be low than normal, and you know the normal value is 7.35 to 7.45. If pH will be less than 7.35, it will be considered and regarded as acidosis. Acidosis will be subclassified into two types, metabolic acidosis and respiratory acidosis. Metabolic acidosis is due to the decrease in bicarbonate ion, while respiratory acidosis is due to the increase in carbonic acid. You will focus at one point, as you have discussed in your first year content also, metabolic disorders will be caused by variation of bicarbonate ion, while the respiratory disorders will be caused by due to the variation of carbonic acid level. In metabolic acidosis, bicarbonate will be decreased. In metabolic alkalosis, bicarbonate will be increased. While in respiratory acidosis, carbonic acid will be high. On the other hand, in respiratory alkalosis, carbonic acid will be low. So, based upon this idea, we will move forward. The four disorders are due to the variation in bicarbonate and carbonic acid. Two disorders are due to the decrease and increase of bicarbonate ion, and two are due to the decrease and increase of carbonic acid. Now, it is confirmed that metabolic disorders means metabolic acidosis and metabolic alkalosis will be due to the up and low value of bicarbonate ion, while respiratory disorders will be due to up and high level, up and down levels of carbonic acid. This slide is very, very important in diagnosing and triggering the particular type of disorder. At first, we will discuss metabolic acidosis. There are few particular conditions which will lead to metabolic acidosis due to decrease in bicarbonate ion, and we will discuss one by one how it is associated to cause decrease in bicarbonate ion. Diabetes mellitus. This disease is a metabolic disorder. If it is uncontrolled in diabetes mellitus, if the disease is uncontrolled, it will lead to ketoacidosis, more and more ketone body production. And this ketoacidosis will decrease the blood pH, and to maintain and to regulate this blood pH, there will be more and more utilization of bicarbonate ion, that is the alkali reserve. So in this way, alkali reserve will be decreased. It will be overutilized to compensate the high acidic load. Second cause is the renal failure. In kidney failure, again there is more and more acid production, and there will be more acid retention. Kidney failure will lead to acid retention in the body, and that will be compensated by high alkali reserve. So again, in renal failure, due to more acid retention, alkali reserve will be utilized. Severe diarrhea. Diarrhea is the direct cause of loss of bicarbonate ions from the body. So in diarrhea, decrease in bicarbonate is confirmed. So diarrhea will lead to metabolic acidosis. Renal tubular acidosis, in which tubular defect is involved to inability to reabsorb bicarbonate ions by the kidney tubules. So when there will be less reabsorption of bicarbonate ion, it will lead to metabolic acidosis, and this process is known as Fanconi's syndrome. Lactic acidosis, it is also associated with the acid retention in the body, lactic acid retention, due to severe exercise and due to high muscular activity. More and more lactic acid will be present in the blood, and it will be compensated, and the decreasing pH due to lactic acidosis will be compensated by high alkali reserve. So our alkali reserve, that is bicarbonate ion, will be utilized to fight against high acidic load. So again, there will be metabolic acidosis. Few minor causes are also associated, like increase in anions other than bicarbonate ion. If the ratio of other anions exceeds in the blood or plasma, comparatively the level of bicarbonate will be observed low. Starvation and high fever, they will be result in lipolysis. Starvation will be associated with the breakdown of lipid and fat, that will lead to more ketone body production. And when there will be more keto acids, there will be decrease in blood pH, that will be associated with high utilization of alkali reserve. Fistulas are holes and openings in ducts, like biliary duct, like pancreatic duct. So there are chances for the loss of bicarbonate ion from these tubules. Addison disease is a hormonal defect in which there is a loss of sodium in the urine, and loss of sodium will also be associated with the bicarbonate ion. So we can say that in Addison disease, the patient would be suffering from metabolic acidosis as well, due to the decrease in bicarbonate ion in blood or plasma. Second condition is metabolic alkalosis. And metabolic alkalosis is associated with different causes. Number one main cause is severe vomiting. In severe vomiting, there will be loss of HCl from the body. And when there is a loss of chloride ion, as you have read in chloride shift, chloride ion is associated with counter compensation with the bicarbonate ion. There is a rule that when chloride is high, bicarbonate will be low, and when bicarbonate is high, chloride will be low. So in severe vomiting, when loss of chloride will be observed, it will be associated with increase in bicarbonate ion. So due to the increase in bicarbonate ion, it will lead to metabolic alkalosis. Hypokalemia, decrease in potassium. How potassium will be decreased? When potassium is decreased in the body due to any particular condition, it will result in more reabsorption of sodium. To maintain the electrical neutrality, when one positive ion is being decreased, it will cause the second compensating ion to be increased. Sodium potassium work in compensation with each other. So when in plasma there will be decrease in potassium, it will be associated with increase in sodium, and sodium will also increase the level of bicarbonate ion to form the alkali reserve. So ultimately hypokalemia will lead to increase in bicarbonate ion, and increase in bicarbonate ion is referred as metabolic alkalosis. Intravenous administration of bicarb, this is done to treat the acidosis. When the pH is low in the body, by the consumption of high acidic food, spicy food, and ingestion of certain acidic drugs, the pH of blood plasma may fall. To treat it, we take the alkaline salts by the injectables or by the oral medication. That will lead to increase in bicarbonate ion in the body, and this is the direct cause of elevation of bicarbonate in plasma, leading to metabolic alkalosis. X-rays and UV radiation, they may cause the long-term exposure for any chemotherapeutic treatment and radiotherapy treatment for the cancer patient. When more and more X-rays are exposed, and more X-rays and UV radiations are used to diagnose and treat any tumor or any cancer or any malignancy, दिस लॉन्ग टर्म एक्सपोजर टू रेडिएशन मे कॉज वॉमिटिंग एंड वॉमिटिंग विल लीड टू मेटाबॉलिक एल्केलोसिस कुशिंग सिंड्रोम. दिस इज द लास्ट वन क्लिनिकल कॉज टू कॉज द मेटाबॉलिक एल्केलोसिस इन कुशिंग सिंड्रोम. देर इज द एड्रिनल कॉर्टेक्स डिसफंक्शन एंड यू नो एड्रिनल कॉर्टेक्स प्रोड्यूसेस हार्मोन एल्डोस्टेरोन. दिस एल्डोस्टेरोन इज मिनरलोकॉर्टिकॉइड दैट इज एसोसिएटेड विद हाई सोडियम रीअब्सॉर्प्शन. सो मोर सोडियम रीअब्सॉर्प्शन विल लीड टू मोर एंड मोर रीअब्सॉर्प्शन ऑफ बायकार्बोनेटाइन एज वेल. एंड दिस फिनोमिना दिस सिंड्रोम दिस डिजीज इज नोन एज कुशिंग सिंड्रोम. थर्ड वन डिसऑर्डर दैट इज ड्यू टू द कार्बोनिक एसिड वेरिएशन इज रेस्पायरेटरी एसिडोसिस. रेस्पायरेटरी एसिडोसिस इज ड्यू टू द इंक्रीज इन कार्बोनिक एसिड. नाउ यू विल फोकस एट वन पॉइंट दैट हाउ इन द बॉडी कार्बोनिक एसिड कैन राइज. टू सिंथेसाइज द कार्बोनिक एसिड वी नीड कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड इट शुड रिएक्ट विद वाटर. So if in the body more and more carbon dioxide will be present, it will form more and more acid and more carbonic acid will lead to respiratory acidosis. Now the question is from where more and more carbon dioxide is coming due to high metabolic activity and due to hypoventilation. You should keep in mind all the causes, all the conditions, all the factors which will lead to hypoventilation. Hypoventilation means breathing at a less rate, shallow rate, slow breathing that will cause more retention of carbon dioxide in the body rather than letting it go out. So when more carbon dioxide will be retained in the body, it will form more acid. And these conditions will be seen in case of severe asthma, pneumonia, cardiac arrest, obstruction in airways. Similarly, depression of respiratory center. You know, medulla is the respiratory center in the brain that sends the pH changes in the blood, and there are few drugs which will depress the respiratory center, and those drugs which will depress the respiratory center, they will lead to hypoventilation, while those drugs which will stimulate the respiratory center, that will lead to hyperventilation. So hypoventilation will lead to retention of carbon dioxide leading to more acid production, while hyperventilation will lead to removal of carbon dioxide leading to less acid production. In case of respiratory alkalosis, the last one and fourth disorder related to acid-base disorder and acid-base disturbance is respiratory alkalosis that will be caused by decrease in carbonic acid. How carbonic acid will be decreased? What are the conditions that are associated with decrease in carbonic acid? They are hyperventilation. All the factors which will lead to hyperventilation will lead to decrease in carbon dioxide from the body, ultimately leading to decrease in carbonic acid. So hyperventilation will be observed in different cases like anemia. In anemia, what is being happening? There is decreased RBC count. When there is decreased RBC count, there is less amount of hemoglobin and there will be oxygen insufficiency. To compensate the decrease and deficiency of oxygen, the cells needs more and more oxygen, so the person will respire at a higher rate. You know, the anemic patients usually complain that they are suffering from a shortness of breath, that is due to insufficiency due to decrease in RBC count, decrease in hemoglobin, decrease in oxygen amount in their cells. So in anemia, the patient will hyperventilate, leading to decrease in carbon dioxide amount that will lead to less carbonic acid, ultimately causing respiratory alkalosis. Same phenomena will be observed in high altitude. When you go to northern areas, in hilly areas, you might have observed that you are respiring at a high rate because the pressure of oxygen is low at that point, at height. Due to low oxygen pressure, due to less amount of oxygen, your cells are again deprived of oxygen and your body will need more oxygen. To compensate this insufficiency of oxygen, your respiratory system will be stimulated and you will hyperventilate. Salicylate drugs. Salicylate poisoning means those drugs or formulation which will contain salicylic acid in their formula, in their composition. This type of drugs will stimulate the respiratory center in brain, and that will lead to decrease in carbonic acid by hyperventilation due to less content of carbon dioxide, leading to respiratory alkalosis. Now, what are the factors that decrease the bicarbonate ion in the body in metabolic acidosis? They are the more production of acid and more utilization of alkali reserve. Why acids will be more produced? Due to metabolic activity, due to high metabolic activity in the tissues, more and more acids will be produced. Like if there is defect in the body, like in case of diabetes mellitus, more ketone bodies will be formed. When there is more acid production, there will be more utilization of alkali reserve. And you know what is alkali reserve? It is bicarbonate ion. Similarly, if there is more lactate production in the body, more lactic acid in the body, your alkali reserve will be utilized at a higher rate to compensate this disturbance. So two causes are there to cause the metabolic acidosis: either more production of acid or more utilization of alkali reserve. The slide is showing a reaction that is the more production of acid in the body and its neutralization with the alkali reserve. NaHCO3 is sodium bicarbonate, that is alkali reserve, that is reacting with is organic acids that are being produced by the body as a result of metabolic activity, and it will lead to sodium salt of organic acid along with carbon dioxide. So this is how the organic acid is captured and pH is neutralized, and alkali reserve is utilized and decreased in the body to fight against acidic load. Now we will talk about compensation of metabolic acids, metabolic acidosis. You know, you should keep in mind one thing, that to treat the metabolic acidosis, there will be two systems, both lines of defense. Number one, respiratory mechanism by the lungs, either by the way of hyperventilation or hypoventilation. And number two, kidney mechanism, renal mechanism, that is either by the retention of proton or excretion of proton, or by the excretion of bicarbonate ion or reabsorption of bicarbonate ion. So in case of metabolic acidosis, there is more acid in the body. Carbonic acid is not associated to cause the metabolic acidosis, rather bicarbonate ion, decrease in bicarbonate ion is causing metabolic acidosis. You know, we have read about the bicarbonate buffer, in which ratio of base to acid is 20:1. When the 20 alkali reserve will be decreased, obviously in ratio acid quantity will be elevated. So what the lungs will do, they cannot increase the bicarbonate ion, because bicarbonate ion is the metabolic component of the bicarbonate buffer, and metabolic component is compensated by the kidney, while the volatile component, that is carbonic acid, will be compensated by the lungs. So the only option that is left with lungs, that is the hyperventilation. Lungs will hyperventilate to release the more and more carbon dioxide from the body so as to decrease the carbonic acid level. So when the carbonic acid will be decreased, bicarbonate ratio will be restored. You will keep in mind that if one entity is being decreased, so the other entity will also decrease to compensate it. If one entity is increased, the other entity will increase. It means these two entities are obviously definitely two components of bicarbonate buffer, because this is the major buffer that is responsible to change the pH of blood, to maintain the pH of blood, bicarbonate ion and carbonic acid. If in any disorder carbonic acid is increased, bicarbonate will be decreased to compensate the effect. If carbonic acid is decreased, bicarbonate will be decreased. If bicarbonate is decreased, carbonic acid will decrease. If bicarbonate is increased, carbonic acid will also increase. And you know how the acid will decrease by the hyperventilation, how the acid will increase by the hypoventilation. Okay, renal mechanism will also take 3 to 4 days to maintain this problem in acidosis. And in acidosis, kidney will do two functions. One is the removal of proton, removal of acid, H+, in the form of ammonium ion and in the form of titratable acid, NaH2PO4. And the second is the working with the bicarbonate ion, एंड इन केस ऑफ मेटाबॉलिक एसिडोसिस व्हेन देर इज ऑलरेडी डिक्रीज इन बायकार्बोनेटाइन किडनी विल नॉट एक्सक्रीट मोर एंड मोर बायकार्बोनेटाइन रादर इट विल मोर एंड इट विल डू मोर रीअब्सॉर्प्शन ऑफ बायकार्बोनेटाइन. रेस्पिरेटरी एसिडोसिस दिस केस इज ऑपोजिट. इन दिस केस देर विल बी हाइपोवेंटिलेशन देर इज मोर कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इन द बॉडी एंड देर इज मोर H2CO3 एसिड प्रोडक्शन इन द बॉडी. So we have discussed the clinical causes that will lead to respiratory acidosis. So we will not go into detail. We will go rather to the compensation. Kidney will involve to compensate this problem. In one thing you should keep in mind, metabolic disorders are compensated both by lungs and kidney. But in case of respiratory disorder, the primary compensating mechanism will be kidney only. Because the problem is already caused by the lungs, so they will not primarily treat it. And now you can easily decide, in case of respiratory acidosis, there is increase in carbonic acid. So to compensate, we should increase the alkali reserve. We should increase the basic component as well. So how the kidney will increase the basic component? It will cause more and more reabsorption of bicarbonatine. And also the second mechanism will be the removal of acid, because there is acidosis. The body wants to get rid of proton. So in the form of tritratable acid, NaH2PO4, and in the form of ammonium ion, NH4+, kidney will excrete proton from the body. Metabolic alkalosis. There is increase in bicarbonatine. We will not go into detail of clinical causes. So we will, because we have already discussed in detail, so we will directly move towards compensation. Again, the compensation will be, as it is metabolic disorder, the compensation will be by lungs and kidney. Lungs will hypoventilate. Because there is more increase of bicarbonatine, now the acid should increase. And how the acid should increase? By the increase of carbon dioxide level. And how the carbon dioxide level will increase in the body? By hypoventilation. The second mechanism is renal mechanism. That will cause more excretion of bicarbonatine, because there is already excess of bicarbonatines in the body. So the body doesn't need more bicarbonatine. So kidney will excrete more and more bicarbonatine via the course of urine. In case of respiratory alkalosis, what is being happening? In case of respiratory alkalosis, there is decrease in carbonic acid due to decrease in carbon dioxide in the body. And why carbon dioxide has been decreased? Due to decrease in carbon dioxide pressure in the body. And we have discussed different causes like anemia, like high altitude, salicylate poisoning, and similarly hysteria. That is a neurological disorder, that is a psychotic syndrome. The patient is in depression. When the patient is needing some sympathy, he or she is in stress, anxiety, depression, he or she will definitely hyperventilate in tension, in stress. So when the patient is hyperventilating, it is he or she is excreting more and more carbon dioxide from the body. So more and more hyperventilation will result in decreased acid production. This is the last disorder that is associated with the decrease in carbonic acid. And when the carbonic acid is decreased in the body should decrease the bicarbonatine as well. Why how bicarbonatine will be decreased by the body? More and more excretion by the kidney. So what is the compensating mechanism in case of respiratory alkalosis? Renal mechanism that will increase the rate of removal of bicarbonatine via urine. There is another disorder that is known as mixed acid base disorder. This disorder involves both disturbances. There may be decrease in bicarbonatine, and there may be increase in carbonic acid. If bicarbonatine is decreased, it is metabolic acidosis. If carbonic acid is increased, it is respiratory acidosis. And if both the symptoms are there, if both the variations are there, the patient is suffering from mixed acidosis. If bicarbonate is increased and carbonic acid is decreased, bicarbonate is increased is diagnosing metabolic alkalosis, decrease in carbonic acid is respiratory alkalosis, and if both are there, it will be mixed alkalosis. So mixed acid base disorders will be when there are three types: mixed acidosis, mixed alkalosis, and mixed acid base disorder. Mixed acid base disorder involves decrease in bicarbonate ion and decrease in carbonic acid. So if the condition is not directing towards a particular situation, we can decide that, we can say that, we can suggest that the patient is suffering from mixed acid base disorder. Now, how that treatment is done? Acidosis involves the decrease in blood pH, so we will give the alkaline salts. The oral intake of sodium bicarbonate, sodium lactate, and sodium gluconate will be done. And these bicarbonate, lactate, and gluconate, the sodium will move towards ECF, that will react with bicarbonate ion, while these negative ions will be metabolized by the cell. So the pH will be increased by the use of these alkaline salts. To treat the alkalosis, acidic salts will be given, like ammonium chloride. You can say that ammonium chloride is a neutral salt. How it will treat the alkalosis? You can see the mechanism, how it is going in the body, how it is being metabolized. Ammonium chloride will be dissociated into ammonia and HCl, and ammonia will go to liver to be used in the urea cycle, by HCl will be broken up, dissociated, ionized in H plus and chloride negative, and we are interested with the H plus, and this more and more proton production will decrease the pH. So treatment of acidosis is by sodium bicarbonate, sodium lactate, and sodium gluconate, while the treatment of alkalosis is by ammonium chloride. There is another salt, that is lysine monohydrochloride, to treat the alkalosis. Lysine monohydrochloride. One slide was missing, that is the compensation of metabolic alkalosis by the lungs. That will be by hypoventilation, as we have discussed. Hypoventilation will lead to reserve of carbon dioxide, retention of carbon dioxide in the body, that will lead to increase the carbonic acid level, and kidney will be involved to excrete more bicarbonate ion in case of metabolic alkalosis, because there is more sufficiency, more plenty of bicarb ions present in the body. So this is all about acid base disorders along with its treatment, and in next lecture we will discuss about arterial blood gases and anion gap. Thank you very much.